Today I'm going to teach you about relay. Have you heard this name? Okay, so have you seen this box type? It has here 5 pins. No, so let's start to know about it. And we also have this relay module that we are going to connect to Arduino Uno board. So let's begin. So firstly, I'm going to tell you about the structure of relay. So see this. This is a electromagnetic relay. Here you can see this. Okay. So this is the structure of the relay, and here this much is a electromagnet, and here are two terminals. You can see. One of these is normally closed, and this is the normally closed. It means we can use it like a switch. Here is the positive terminal, and it goes from here to the normally closed. Means at this point it is attached. So afterwards, when we just give the power to electromagnet, here we are giving the power to electromagnet. So what will happen? This pole is a metallic pole, so it will come downwards. Okay, so this pole will go downwards, so absolutely this current here flowing will break. So now what will happen? Now this pole will just come here like this and will be connected to here. Okay, so it means now from this it's connected absolutely. So now this is like a switch only. So why it is used? First I'm going to tell you. You know, we don't just connect the motor to Arduino board because it can just take more current from it and just short circuit the Arduino Uno board. And we don't just connect the 9 volt battery to it because that can also just damage it. So the thing we do it. So what we do is, we just don't connect the 9 volt battery to our Arduino board. So what we do is, this is our 9 volt battery and we just connect it to our relay. So what will happen is, the 9 volt will not reach to the Arduino board. Okay, so you know now the relay is like an electronic switch. So see this. Okay, so this is a diagram. So this is a motor and this is a 9 volt battery. So like a switch we have done the connections. So here it is like a switch. So when this Arduino board says to activate the relay activates and it just connects these both wires. So when the relay activates, this electromagnet will activate surely and this rod will just come down. So here this will connect, and so here this both wire will connect and our circuit will activate. So our Arduino board will do not get the 9 volt connection. So there are less chances to just short circuit. Okay, so we have here our relay look like this. So here it have 5 pins. So what are these 5 pins? So these both here, these both top 2 pins. Here at the top there are 2 pins, these both. So these top 2 pins are for the electromagnet. So this electromagnet has 2 pins, positive and negative getting, and here remains the 3 pins. This one and this two. Okay, so relay is the box like this, and here are the pins like this. So positive and negative for electromagnet. So this is a common, and this is normally closed, normally open. So what are these common and normally closed, normally open? So here you can see the switch means battery wire will come from here, and that will attach to the normal, that will attach to the common. So in normally closed the circuit is normally closed, and as you say Arduino board to activate this relay, this rod will come down, so the circuit will just off. So it means this can work oppositely also. So it can just activate the motor forever, and as we say the command, so it will just stop the motor. This can work like this also. And if we want is normally open, means the circuit will be remain normally open. So the second wire of the motor will come here on the normally open. So here the circuit is normally open. As you give the command will activate the circuit. Okay, so it works like this. So today we have with us this relay module. This relay module connects to our Arduino board. It here has three wires to connect, and here three. This is VCC, GND. So see this. Okay, so there are three wires: VCC, GND, and input. This one is input, VCC, and GND. Okay, so then here are also three. So these three are this center one is the normal one. In this common, this center is this common. And both of them, one of the them is normally closed and normally open. You have to figure it out. So today we have two programs. In one program we are going to just run this without any motor or pump. So to just see it working, it just makes the sound of clicking, click click. So as this rod reaches down, it will make the sound of click, up, then also click. So we will just see the sound, and for that we will just make it work with the help with along a LED. So I will show you, and the next program we are going to just connect. No need to write any extra program. We are just going to connect here our battery and motor with the help of this relay. No need for any extra program. So let's see how it does. First we will see the program, then the connections. INT LED pin 13, the LED positive leg will go on 13 pin, and GND grounds negative leg, then INT relay pin 3. So relay, the here are three pins in the relay. So these three pins here are three pins, just it is actually blur. Okay, here you can see here are three pins. This input pin will go to relay pin, that is input pin, so it will go pin number 3. Here this GND will go to GND, and VCC 5 volt. Okay, so then setup starts here. Pin mode, declaring the pin mode. LED and relay both are output. So loop starts here. Digital right, LED pin high and relay pin high. So both will on at the same time, and then after 5 seconds the both will just off. So this is our program. So I will show you how it works. So this our connections are done. So as our LED is offing, here is the sound. So see, on then also sound, and off then also sound. So here I have also done the connections for the motor. So I will show you here is the motor. Here comes our motor. So I have just connected, this is a leg of battery, this one. So what you have to do is just connect it to the normally when the LED is on, that time only our motor should be on. So here I have, and as our LED offs, the motor is also offing. So like this it works. Okay, so thank you.